aren't. My name is Steve Ginty. I'm the Director of Cyber Intelligence here at RiskIQ. We focus on helping customers understand their attack surface and how they can defend their organizations from threats online. We're a multi-focus team across threat intelligence, vulnerability, and vulnerability intelligence. We're looking to understand an organization's attack surface, how actors could potentially target an organization, what are the vulnerabilities or the devices that they have that are internet-facing that an actor could use to gain access to their organization. And we all want to understand the actors behind the attacks, the vulnerabilities they leverage, their motivations, and how we can better help an organization defend against this. I think the pace is really the biggest differentiator. There's been a much broader scale of attacks against a broader scale of organizations. There's an increase in disclosures of vulnerabilities and the vulnerabilities that actors use to target organizations. And so I think back over the span of 10 years, I like to think about time compression. We have a lot less time to react to a lot more things. The primary thing that organizations need to have is visibility. You need to understand what your attack surface is and who the threat actors are that are targeting you in order to be effective in defending your environment. That information changes on a monthly and quarterly basis. You spin up new systems. Actors find new ways to target organizations and their infrastructure. And so visibility is key for organizations to start to answer questions as new threats emerge and as things change in their environment. And so I think that's really, really the key from our standpoint and my standpoint is if you don't know what your attack surface is, you can't answer critical questions about the risk profile to your organization as this new information comes up. I think if you look at the vulnerability landscape that an organization has to tackle, it can seem very daunting. The National Institute of Standards and Technology noted that there are over 18,000 vulnerabilities disclosed in 2021. But an organization isn't going to have to respond to all of those, and two, not all of those are going to reach a critical kind of threshold for an organization to be worried about. And so, really focusing in on those vulnerabilities that threat actors leverage and that target your industry and organization. A starting point for organizations who want to approach understanding their external attack surface really comes down to cataloging an understanding of critical assets that are internet connected and critical third-party suppliers that support those assets to understand your exposure. And so you can start this as a thought exercise for any major organization of what are my critical IT assets? What are the critical suppliers that I have inside of my organization that would cause harm to my business if those things went down? And do I have visibility into them? One of the areas that my team focuses on and that we have a handful of very talented analysts that focus on is what we call infrastructure analysis, looking at RiskIQ's global collection and understanding how we can track actors and the infrastructure they use to conduct their attack campaigns and how we effectively fingerprint that and surface new assets as those bad actors stand them up on the internet. And so it's kind of the opposite side of the coin of an organization's attack service. It's what is the infrastructure of our adversary and how do we effectively fingerprint and track that going forward. And as we can signature and identify those things, it really allows an organization to proactively understand what an actor may be doing, maybe when they're standing up an attack campaign, and gives insight into known threats. It pairs very well with if you know the adversaries that are targeting your organization, and you can track them going forward. You can, I wouldn't say get ahead, but you can try to keep pace a bit with that evolving adversary. And that's a real big focus of fingerprinting that infrastructure across our data collection. It's really important that organizations not only understand their attack surface, but that they use our data and our collection to track adversaries as well. We're really trying to fine tune our detection points so that we have visibility into what bad actors are doing and we can better enable our customers to defend against them.